Class 11, we will see about electronegativity in this video, and you know about the electronegativity, that this particular property of periodic table occurs in the covalent compounds, and you know that the covalent compounds are always formed by sharing of electrons, you know. For example, if you talk about A and A, so this is a covalent compound, and it is showing in this manner. So electron is being there, so this is a pure covalent compound in which both the atoms are same, similar atoms are there, and there is no polarity is being there, right? So if there is no polarity, so whatever the electrons are there, they will be equally distributed among the atoms. But if you come across with the particular covalent compound in which both the atoms are different, then in this, the particular atom, the one which is more electronegative in nature, the electron will be drifted or shifted towards that particular atom, है ना, इसकी तरफ ज़्यादा इधर. तो there will be a partial negative charge and a partial positive charge will be developed in that case of covalence, right? So in this particular condition, over here there was no polarity because both the atoms were same and the electrons were equally distributed. But over here the electrons were unequally distributed. This will be more electronegative, it will be less electronegative. So they are polar, you know, we were having two particular compounds, polar covalent compounds and non-polar covalent compounds. If you remember, polar covalent compounds and non-polars. So the first example which I discuss, it's related to your non-polar covalent compounds. So there was no polarity was generated, but this was the case of the second first one, polar covalent compounds. So they were showing the polarity, so they were polar molecules, and I have discussed that both the atoms are different, one is more electronegative, other is less electronegative. Over here, if you see this B is more electronegative than A. So electrons were shifted towards B. So it acquires a partial negative charge, A acquires a partial positive charge on it. So they were showing, they are polar molecules, they were showing polarity over it. So you'll say it's a polarity, and polarity they were showing, and this starts behaving as partial ionic, right? Just see, you know that ionic compound, if it was an ionic compound, then both the electrons were, this particular atom is having the electron, it will transfer to this case. So if you see, they are also showing this will acquire a this thing, and this will the part positive charge over here, and this will having a negative charge, but over here partial charges were generated. So this was the case of your polar molecules, where they were showing the polarity, and they were behaving, or they were showing as a partial ionic in nature. So that was the case. So that was they having a partial negative charge and partial positive charge was developed. Now this particular phenomena, the second one, this one phenomena was explained by one scientist that was known as Linus Pauling. So we are not talking about the scientists and the names and in which year they invented that, but you should understand. So this particular thing was introduced a new term, and that was known as your electronegativity, was that term that was introduced with this by this Linus Pauling. So I think it's clear to you. So what happened is, when the particular atom in which one is more electronegative in nature, it's tried to attract the electrons towards itself, or basically the shared pair of electrons which were present in them was shifted or drifted towards the particular atom which is more electronegative in nature. Over here, B is more electronegative in nature and it is less electronegative in nature. So the electrons were shifted. It is not we are not transferring. I am telling you, it shifted or drifted towards B. So that's why it acquire a positive charge over here, and partial positive, and it's acquire a partial negative charges over here. So this atom is more electronegative, and this is less electronegative, right? You are getting my point. So what was the definition, if you remember? The tendency of an atom to attract the bonding or the shared pair of electrons towards its own side in a covalent bond is known as electronegativity of that atom. So that was the case. This was the definition I'm again showing you. So the definition is from year to year, which you have discussed in class 10th also. So please remember that. Now there were different scales that were generated for measuring the electronegativities. So first was the Pauling's scales. These things are not required, but still Pauling's scale, we'll see to it when two different atoms are there and they are having different electronegativities, so how you can generate. And second is your Malkin's scale. This is important because this is there in our course. So there was a this thing, the if you want to calculate the electronegative of a particular atom, so this is I am discussing. So it's has a formula that is you know each and every atom must be having the ionization energy. So the first ionization energy you have to use, and electron affinity you have to use, and you have to just do the arithmetic mean of it divided by 2. So this will give you a value of electronegativity. So x is electronegativity, this is first ionization enthalpy or potential, this is electron affinity. So you have to give the arithmetic mean. So 2 are there, divided by 2, you'll get the value for electronegativity. So this was given by Malkin's, and the scale was generated. Basically what happened to two atoms were, whatever you are using, the combining atom, you have to make it a show that they should have the similar electronegativities, means they should be purely covalent in nature. And difference in the electronegativity of the atoms that forms the bond is that is partially ionic. So when the suppose karo पर्टिकुलर जो भी तुम्हारा एटम आ रहा है वो आप देख रहे हो ना कि दोनों एटम्स, उसमें आपको क्या लेना है, सेम लेना है, जो कि जिनकी इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी विल आल्सो बी सिमिलर. एंड अगर आप डिफरेंट लोगे तो फिर डिफरेंट लोगे तो उसमें अलग आपकी कंडीशन आती है. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल अगर कोई दो एटम्स है और आपने अगर उनकी वैल्यूज को देखा और अगर उसकी वैल्यू करीबन 1.7 या 1.8 आ रही है, तो यानी उसके मतलब ये हो गया कि वो 50% उसकी वैल्यू आ रही है जो कि आयनिक कंडीशंस को शो कर रही है. ठीक है, तो दिस इज़ नॉट रिक्वायर्ड बट स्टिल आई एम जस्ट डिस्कसिंग विद यू. इफ यू वांट आई कैन टेल यू द पॉलिंग स्केल्स फॉर्मूला आल्सो. दिस इज आई एम शोइंग यू फ्रॉम योर बुक. सो पॉलिंग स्केल्स का है. सो इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस यह दिया रखा है दो पर्टिकुलर एटम्स का, और ये एक फॉर्मूला है, दो एटम्स हैं ए और बी, उनके लिए जो इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी का डिफरेंस है वो एक्स ए माइनस एक्स बी है, ये पूरा फॉर्मूला है. Now they have given the XA means electronegativity of an atom A, this is B. XA minus B, the formula mein diya rakha hai bond energy of the bond A and B in the molecule AB. This is bond energy of BB in the molecule A2. Bond energy of bond BB in the molecule B2. So this has been there. This is not required, I'm again telling you. Please, still you have a look on it. Now you'll focus on the factors, on which this particular periodic property, that is electronegativity, depends. So we have four factors which you have to focus. The first one is effective nuclear charge. The second is size of the atom. Third is oxidation state. And fourth is state of hybridization. I'm again telling you there are different factors. There are other factors also. When you see different videos, then you'll focus on the different factors. But in our course, we have these factors. Right, you will see in the syllabus also they have given you like in terms of valence electrons or shielding effects or size of atom or effective nuclear charge or states of hybridization or oxidation state. So please, it's not necessary that these factors will come in all the properties. It's depend on property to property which factors you are using. Like in the previous video in ionization potential, I have mentioned you that in that case the factors were different. It was shielding effect was there, your electronic configuration was there, your penetration effect was there. So that time we were not focusing on the oxidation state or hybridization, but in electronegativity we are focusing on these four factors. So let's talk on them one by one. Let's first focus on the effective nuclear charge. I think effective nuclear charge is clear to you now, that what is the effective nuclear charge. But still I am telling you that the effective nuclear charge, if it is higher, suppose this is your particular atom and this is the nucleus, so definitely this effective nuclear charge will be on the nucleus. So if it is high, so this particular, you know, this nucleus have the tendency to attract the electrons towards itself. Even it's not only we are in the videos or in the books, it's always written that they are only attracting the valence electron. It's positive charge, electrons are negatively charged, so definitely all the electrons are attracted by the nucleus. But we are mainly focusing on the this thing, valence electrons, and the electrons which are coming from outside. So this particular, if this effective nuclear charge is more, so it will attract the electron with a greater extent comparison to a atom having a less effective nuclear charge. So if this particular atom having a large or high effective nuclear charge, so it will attract this particular electron, the valence electrons, more effectively. And even the electron that is coming from outside, it will attract that electron also very effectively. So what you get the conclusion that high is your effective nuclear charge, so greater will be the tendency to attract the electrons towards it, basically the shared pair of electrons, and even the electrons that is coming from outside, because over here there is the tendency of attracting the electrons, na? So they are attracting the shared pair of electrons over here, even the electrons that are coming out, and even the, which we have already discussed in electron gain enthalpy, when the electron was coming from outside. Now over here, this particular nuclear charge, the effective nuclear charge, is attracting the shared pair of electrons, it's pulling the shared pair of electrons towards itself. So what you get the conclusion that higher the effective nuclear charge, greater the tendency to pull the shared pair of electrons towards itself. Right, and because of it, your electronegativity will increase. Okay, now vice versa, it's not every time your nuclear charge is more, sometimes the effective nuclear charge is less. So the statement will be entirely different, that lesser the effective nuclear charge, less will be the tendency to pull the shared pair of electrons, and less will be your electronegativity. So this is the first factor which we have discussed. Now we'll focus on the size of the atom. You just focus on it. Suppose if your particular atom size is big, what do you think of it? Your electronegativity will increase or decrease? It will decrease. Jitna bada size hai, utna hi aapki electronegativity decrease hoti jayegi. So atomic size is inversely proportional to electronegativity. Is baat ko dhyan rakhna. Vice versa rahega. If your atomic size is more, electronegativity is less. If your atomic size is less, electronegativity will be more. So this thing, if it is less, it is more. If it is more, it is less. So this way you have to understand. Now the third point is oxidation state. Oxidation state of an atom is it's also very important, that it's always the formal charge that is present on a particular atom. जैसे ये इसके पास formal charge है, तो इसका ये oxidation state इसकी क्या है? +3 है. ठीक है. So higher the oxidation state, greater will be the electronegativity. ठीक है. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल अगर हमने Fe+2 ले लिया और Fe+3 ले लिया, और मैंने पूछा इन दोनों में से किसकी इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी ज़्यादा होगी, तो आप ऑटोमेटिकली कह दोगे इसकी. वाई? बिकॉज ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट ऑफ Fe इज मोर. ठीक है, अगर मैं आपको SN+2 दूँ और SN+4 दूँ, तो आप तुरंत कहेंगे मैम SN+4, बिकॉज द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इज मोर. सो हायर द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट, हायर विल बी योर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी. आई थिंक दिस इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल. Now the last one is the state of hybridization. Now state of hybridization, in this you have to focus. Now this is a new term, because this thing we'll discuss in the chemical bonding, and maybe possibly this concept is not clear over here by you all, but still I'm trying to explain you that state of hybridization is also affecting your electronegativity of a particular atom. So in this, greater the S corrector, greater will be your electronegativity. That you have to keep it in mind. जितना ज़्यादा S का character होगा, उतनी ज़्यादा आपकी electronegativity होगी. मतलब S का character जो होगा, that will be directly proportional to your electronegativity. Means if it is high, then your electronegativity will be high. If it is low, it will be low. So just focus on it. Over here, how many S characters are there? एक S है यहाँ and one S है और three P's हैं, है ना? यहाँ पे क्या है? One S है and you have two P's. One S है and over one P is there. So if you see the characters of, अगर इसको हम assume कर लें कि ये 100 से relate up है, ठीक है? तो 100 से आप देख लीजिए, तो ये कितना percent हुआ है इसका? सिर्फ 25% है, ठीक है? यहाँ पे कितना हो गया? इट्स अबाउट 33.3% एंड ओवर या दे आर 50%, है ना? 50-50% रेशियो है इनका एस का करेक्टर्स. सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक, इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी किसकी ज़्यादा होना चाहिए? इसकी ज़्यादा होगी. एस पी की इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी ज़्यादा होगी बिकॉज यू आर हैविंग द मोर एस करेक्टर्स ओवर या. सो दैट्स वाई आई हैव रिटन ओवर या. इफ इट इज़ लेस देन इट विल बी लेस. यानी सबसे कम किस में होगी? एस पी थ्री में इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी. और कितनी किस में सबसे ज़्यादा होगी? एस पी में इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी ज़्यादा होगी. तो आई थिंक दिस इज़ क्लियर टू यू. नाउ दिस पॉइंट, इट वॉज द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ इट. नाउ वील फोकस इट्स वेरिएशन इन योर पीरियड्स एंड ग्रुप. Now children, we have written a period over here, and if you remember this thing we have discussed many times, it is an alkali metal, and alkali metals are always electro positive in nature, and this F is what your, it's an halogen and it is a electronegative in nature. You know that halogens are always highly electronegative in nature and they shows their electronegativity character is very more. So they are halogens electronegative and they have a high characters of this. This is the seventh group members if you remember it, and this was your first group. Now alkalis are always coming in the first group and halogens are always coming in the in 17 group. So if you see that these alkali metals are electropositive in nature and halogens are electronegative in nature. So what is the case? What do you think so about it? That if you compare in terms of electronegativity, so whose electronegativity is less? Lithium's electronegativity is less because it's an electropositive element. It don't have the tendency to share the electrons or attract the electrons. This thing you have to keep in mind. Electropositive, the elements or the atoms if you're talking about, they don't have the tendency to attract the electrons, or they don't have the tendency to gain the electrons or to pull the shared pair of electrons towards them. So over here they are not even sharing or pair, or they are not pulling the shared pair of electrons towards them, this electropositive elements. And this is, they have a tendency to attract the shared pair of electrons towards themselves, so they have the highest electronegativity. So when you move from left to right, we always read in this manner, left to right in a period, then you see that electronegativity always increases. So in periods, electronegativity increases. I think now it's clear to you all that this particular over here, the element, if you're seeing, they are electropositive atoms or electropositive elements, and they don't have the tendency to pull the shared pair of electrons toward itself. But over here, this is halogens. Halogens have highest electronegativity, this you have seen, and they are electronegative elements. They have the tendency to pull the shared pair of electrons toward itself, so they have the highest value of electronegativities in the periods. So that's why when we move from left to right in a period, the electronegativity increases. Now let's focus about on the groups also. I'll write down the group. One more thing, you please focus on the period. If somebody asks you in terms of reasoning, then what you will say? This is the general idea, but you will also tell about the factors. Over here you have to focus on the factors also, like hybridization. So it is not required over here because you don't know just now about the hybridization, but you know the size of the atom. So what do you think about the size of the atom? In the period, the size of the atom is decreasing, and I have already mentioned you that if the size of the atom is vice versa, you know, it's related with size of the atom and the electronegativity is inversely proportional to each other. And if you focus on that, ki the size of the atom is decreasing in the period, so electronegativity is increasing. Ek to ye point hua aapke paas, theek hai? Aur yahi baat, dusri baat hui ki it's electropositive over here, it's electronegative. This is the second point. Now effective nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge, I have always mentioned you, whether it is a group or whether it is a period, it's always increasing. if I'm going fast, then let me know about it. That they always, this particular factor is that in groups as well as in periods, it increases. तो आप इसको करने के लिए आपको पहले, मैं सोचती हूँ ग्रुप से पहले लेट्स फोकस ऑन द फैक्टर्स ऑल्सो टू गिव द आंसर ओवर या. देखो यहाँ पर आपका इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज चार्जेस इंक्रीजिंग हो रहा है ना, इंक्रीज हो रहा है ना न्यूक्लियर चार्ज. सो योर इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिविटी इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग, राइट. सेकेंड पॉइंट यू कैन एक्सप्लेन इन टर्म्स ऑफ दिस थिंग है ना, एल्कली मेटल्स एंड हेलोजन्स, ये वाला पॉइंट भी डाल देना इसमें. देन योर साइज ऑफ द एटम, साइज ऑफ द एटम इज डिक्रीजिंग इन पीरियड्स, राइट. देयरफॉर इन्वर्सली होता है ना, इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिविटी इज इंक्रीजिंग. तो आप देख रहे हो हर जगह आपकी इंक्रीजिंग ही इंक्रीजिंग आ रही है इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी. दो पॉइंट्स आपने क्लियर कर दिए, मोर देन है ना. देर इज़ नो आइडिया टू गो फॉर द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट, क्योंकि यहाँ पे ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट से आप एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर पाएंगे, ठीक है. सो आई थिंक दीज टू पॉइंट्स आर मोर क्लियर टू यू एंड यू कैन इजली. एंड थर्ड पॉइंट आप ये लगा दीजिएगा कि इधर इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव एलिमेंट्स होते हैं, इधर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव. इस पॉइंट को भी ज़रूर लेके चलना, थर्ड पॉइंट जब भी अगर एक्सप्लेनेशन का है तो ये पॉइंट को भी ज़रूर एड ऑन करना. नाउ लेट्स फोकस ऑन द ग्रुप एंड आई हैव रिटन वन ग्रुप. दिस ग्रुप इज फेमिलियर टू यू ऑल. वी हैव डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस दैट इन पीरियड्स दैट द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी वॉज इंक्रीजिंग, बट इन ग्रुप इज इट विल डिक्रीज. नाउ हाउ इट इज डिक्रीजिंग दैट यू हैव टू फोकस. The first point is that you know that effective nuclear charge is increases. In all the cases I mentioned you that it will increase. So in that scenario, your electronegativity is directly proportional to it. It will also increase. But if you focus on the size of the atom, it increases here. In groups when you move from top to bottom. So when its size of the atom was inversely proportional to the electronegativity, size of the atom increases, electronegativity decreases. This thing you have to keep it in mind, right? So first scenario you are getting increase, other is the decrease. So size of the atom dominates over effective nuclear charge. So in groups, electronegativity decreases. This thing you have to keep it in mind. Now the point arises that whenever you are making it, you have to focus on it that these particular terms are very important, that you have to focus in terms of groups and the periods. You have to show them in groups and period, and even in the individual elements also. Anyone can ask you about anything, like they can compare you with a alkali metal and with a halogen. Then you know that if this is a particular halogen, it is an alkali metal, you can easily say, ma'am, this will have the high electronegativity. But your answer is not this much. Your answer is you have to prove with the help of the factors. In class 10th, we were not at all proving with the help of the factors. We were only seeing the increase and decrease part. Okay, who is showing where, matlab in the groups it is increasing or decreasing. That was our last limit. But in class 11, your standard is high. So when if the teacher asks you among the particular, if they give you any elements and they ask you that whose electronegativity is more or less, then you have to, apart from that thing, you have to prove it with the help of the reasonings and with the help of the factors. And the factors should be there in your syllabus. There are other factors also. You may have seen different videos from your online classes or some other teachers' videos, but they may be from IITs or NEETs one. So please don't focus on that point. Only focus your syllabus factors. Don't go beyond the syllabus. So in this case, one more thing you have to arise is that fluorine have the most, they are electro negative element, right? And these alkalis have the least, they have no electronegativity because they are electro positive atoms. So please make sure that you complete this part, and we have covered up with the most of the properties. Few things are left, then I'll make another video and we'll discuss in that. Meanwhile, you please go through this electronegativity and please go how it varies in your group and periods, and even compare it with the help of the these things, particular your factors. If you have given these two elements, you will not say that it is electropositive or electronegative, but you all have to say other things also about the effective nuclear charge, which is more, because ये दोनों एक ही, अगर आप रिजेंबल करें तो ये दोनों एक ही पीरियड्स में आ रहे हैं, तो इलेक्ट्रो जो आपका न्यूक्लियर चार्ज है वो इंक्रीज़ हो रहा है, ठीक है. एटॉमिक साइज डिक्रीज हो रहा है एफ का, है ना. भले ही दो हैं लेकिन आपको मालूम है आज क्या क्या है, तो आपको वो दोनों फैक्टर्स यहाँ पे एक्सप्लेन करने पड़ेंगे कि न्यूक्लियर चार्ज इज मोर फॉर दिस थिंग फ्लोरीन, ठीक है, एंड इट्स एटॉमिक साइज इज लेस, सो इट विल शो high electronegative. So these two factors you have to write down over here, and then you have to give your answer. So please go through the video and do the questions whatever have been asked related to these factors.